Hello students, now in this video let us see some theorems on complete residue system, reduced residue system and some examples. Now the theorem 1 it says if x1, x2 and so on up to xm be a complete residue system modulo m and if a is some integer which is relatively prime with m, then the set of integers ax1 ax2 and so on up to what axm is a complete residue system modulo m. Now what this theorem says, x1 x2 so on up to xm, these are m integers and m different integers forms a complete residue system modulo m, and if that if any other integer which is relatively prime with this m, then if we take the product of that new integer with these integers which forms a complete residue system modulo m, then the new system forms, obviously these are new integers, that new integers also form a complete residue system modulo m. Now the proof of this one is not in our syllabus. If you want, you can go for the proof using the definition. Simply prove the conditions given in the definition and you can prove this one. Now the next theorem 2 says if R1, R2 and so on up to RK be a reduced residue system modulo m and if a and m are relatively prime, then ar1 ar2 and so on up to ark is a reduced residue system modulo m. Reduced residue system modulo m. Now both the things are near about much more similar. Here it is about the complete residue system, here it is about the reduced residue system. Now the reduced residue system only one condition is more, that here each this ri is relatively prime with m, otherwise it is also a complete residue system. Fine. So here we have to prove that this R1, R2, RK is a reduced residue system modulo m, and again A is some new integer which is relatively prime with this m, then this product of A with each RI also forms a reduced residue system modulo m. Now here the proof of this reduced residue system modulo m is in our syllabus, so let us prove it. That one gives you idea to prove this one also if you want. Fine. So now let us go for the proof of this. What is given? Given that this R1, R2, so on up to RK forms a reduced residue system modulo m and A and M are relatively prime. Given that R1, R2 and so on up to what RK be a reduced residue system modulo m and M are relatively prime. therefore the set AR1, AR2 and so on up to ARK contains K number of integers, okay. Now what we have to prove, our claim that these k number of integers forms a reduced residue system. Claim AR1, AR2 and so on up to what? ARK defines a reduced residue system. System modulo m, that is our claim here. So now to prove this thing, we will use the definition of reduced residue system. Now the first condition in the definition says each of these should be relatively prime with whom? M. So now first condition, now first of all we know A and M are relatively prime, and as R1, R2, RK forms a reduced residue system modulo M, means this each RI relatively prime with whom? M. That is the condition of reduced residue system. So each RI is relatively prime with whom? M. Okay. Here I can say for all I from 1 to what? K. For all I from 1 to K. Fine. Therefore, this implies, now A is relatively prime with M, RI is also relatively prime with M. So from this we can say A, RI and M are also what? Relatively prime. This for all I from 1 to so on up to what? K. This is using the properties of GCD. We had already proved such a thing. If A and B are relatively prime, if C and B are relatively prime, then AC and B are also what? Relatively prime. That is a property of GCD here. So now this is about the first condition of reduced residue system is proved. Now the second condition, what does it say? If RI and RJ, I and J are different, then if I not equal to J, then RI is not congruent to RJ modulo M. This is our second condition here. So that one we have to prove for these integers here. Fine. So now what is here? Suppose, now let me assume these are congruent. On a contrary, let us we go. Suppose ARI congruent to ARJ modulo M. For some I not equal to J. Fine. Let us assume this as such. I not equal to J, but ARI congruence to ARJ modulo M. Fine. But this gives us that RI congruence to RJ modulo M. Why does this? Because A and M are relatively prime. So we can cancel it from both the sides. As it is relatively prime with M, so we can cancel it. We get RI congruence to RJ modulo M. And what is the condition with us? With what I can say? I not equal to J. So this contradicts to the fact that R1, R2 and so on up to RK be the given, be what? The reduced residue system modulo M, which contradicts with the given thing. That's why, means our assumption is wrong. So this should not happen, while these are not congruent to each other. Fine. Which is a contradiction to R1, R2 and so on up to what? Rk be a reduced residue system modulo M. Now, the third thing, we have to prove that there exists, for a given integer x, there exists only one integer among these which is congruent to that one modulo m. So now, here also let us assume by contradiction. Suppose for a given integer x, there exist ARi, ARj, such that what? X congruence to ARi modulo M and X congruence to ARj modulo M. Suppose two different integers are there. Okay, fine. Now, as we know, for i not equal to j, that is, it is same as to say ARi congruent to x modulo m. If a congruent to b, b also congruence to a, this one, and x congruence to what? ARj modulo m. Okay, now ARi congruence to x congruence to ARj, so ARi should congruence to ARj modulo m by transitivity. Fine, so ARi congruence to whom? ARj modulo m, and I not equal to what? J. Therefore, this is a contradiction, and also this tells us this is a contradiction to this second one. So also this may give us Ri congruence to what? Rj modulo M. I not equal to J. Fine. Now this is what? A contradiction. Which is a contradiction. Contradiction to again R1, R2, so on up to what? Rk be a reduced residue system modulo M. Okay, therefore finally I can say thus for every x in z there exists only one ARi such that x congruence to whom? ARi modulo M. So, we have been proved all the conditions in the definitions of reduced residue system modulo M. So, finally, we can say, therefore, by definition of reduced residue system modulo M, this AR1, AR2, so on up to ARk forms a reduced residue system modulo M. So, at last, let me write. The part of a proof itself, the final line of proof. Thus, by definition of reduced residue system modulo m. By definition of reduced residue system modulo m, this AR1, AR2 and so on up to ARK defines a reduced residue system modulo m. This is about this theorem, proof of the theorem. Now here let me take a very small example. I can say an example here. For suppose m is equal to 6. So if m is equal to 6, then we know there are infinitely many reduced residue systems modulo 6 are there, but among the one out of them, let us take 1 and 5 is what? This is a small reduced residue system modulo m means what here? 6. M means 6. Fine. Now as let us take 7. 7 is relatively prime with whom? 6. So in place of A, I am taking 7 here. This one plays a role of R1 and R2 here. So if 7 is relatively prime with 6, then here, look at here, this 7 and 30. 7 and 30, how does we have taken it? We have been multiplied by, here, we have been multiplied by 7 here. 7 and what? It should be 7 and 35. 7 and 35 is also what? Is also a reduced residue system. Is also reduced residue system modulo 6. Here, the same thing I have been given here. You can remember here 6 and 7 are relatively prime, 6 and 35 are also relatively prime, and they are not, if I, these are not congruent to each other, fine, as modulo m, fine, and there exist, if x is any integer, then only one of them is congruent to that integer modulo m, fine. So this is an example for this theorem. Now let me go for the next theorem. Next theorem is this Euler's theorem. This is very important theorem. Remember, this is important theorem in future also. Now what the statement of this? Let m be positive integer m be any positive integer and a is any other integer, fine, if a and m are relatively prime, then a raised to phi of m, you know, phi is Euler's phi function, a phi of m congruence to 1 modulo m. Phi of m is set of all integers less than m and relatively prime with m, that is Euler's phi function. Now let us see the proof of this. What this theorem says, m and a are any two integers such that they are relatively prime with each other, then a raised to phi of m congruence to 1 modulo m. So now let R1, R2, so on up to RK be reduced residue system modulo m, modulo m. As a and m are relatively prime, then as we see in previous theorem, AR1, AR2, so on up to ARK is also a reduced residue system modulo M. Is also reduced residue system modulo M. Fine. Now, if this is the case, therefore, for every ARI, there exist one and only one RJ such that what ARI congruence to RJ. If this forms a reduced residue system, then ARI is any integer, then there exist one and only one RJ such that they are what congruence to each other modulo M. This is by definition. Also, R1, R2 and so on up to RK are the residues of whom AR1, AR2 and so on up to ARK. These are residues of these one, modulo M. But not necessary these are in same order. Means it may happen this, the residue of AR2 will be somewhere between AR5, AR6, AR2 will be R5, R6, whatever it as, but not in same order. We don't know about it. It may be in order or may not be in order, but most probably it will not in a order. Therefore, this says AR1 into AR2 into so on up to what? ARK congruence to R1, R2, so on up to what? RK modulo M. Since RI and M are relatively prime, for all I from 1, 2, so on up to what? K, we get, as these are relatively prime, this is by definition, fine, these are relatively prime, from that we get, these are get cancelled, so we get A, how many times? Here, K times. Here A into A and so on up to A. But how many are these? These are K in numbers. Congruence to whom? Here what left? 1. Modulo M. Fine. That is A raised to K congruence to whom? 1 modulo M. A raised to K congruence to 1 modulo M. So here, this K, what does this K? This K is the number of elements. K is what? The number of elements in reduced residue system. Number of elements in reduced residue system. Modulo M. But we know that the number of positive integers less equal less than or equal to m and relatively prime to m is nothing but what? Euler's phi function. Therefore, k is equivalent to whom? Euler's phi function. We know that the number of positive integers less than or equal to whom? M, and relatively prime to m, is phi of m. Is what? Phi of m. This is phi. Phi of m. Therefore, k is what? Phi of m. So, let us put up the value of k here. It will give us a raised to phi of m congruence to what? 1 modulo m. As such, we can prove this theorem. What this says, if R1, R2, RK is a reduced residue system, we are assuming this, then by previous theorem, this AR1 will also forms what? The reduced residue system modulo m. So, as this is a reduced residue system, so for any ARI, there exists one and only RJ. These are such that the congruence will hold in between them. Means ARI has a residue RJ here. So from that, this one forms what? The residues for these one. But not necessary, they are in a same order. So if this is the case, let us take the product of all of them. Now here, as this is a reduced residue system modulo m, so ARI is congruence, it is relatively prime with m. So from the, here, these RIs get cancelled. So here the product of A only congruence with 1 modulo m. And these are, how many A's are there? These are k in number. So A raised to k congruence to 1 modulo m we get. What is this k? K is this number. K is the number of elements. These are number of elements in reduced residue system modulo m. But these are also what? The number. These are number of positive integers less than or equal to what? M. These are all positive integers less equal m and that are relatively prime to m. So this is equivalent to phi of m. Euler's phi function. That's why k is equal to phi of m. And this is the proof of this theorem. Now the corollary of Euler's theorem. The corollary of Euler's theorem is known as Fermat's theorem. That is also important one. Let us see that corollary. This is Fermat's theorem. Now it has two parts. Let P be a prime, then first one, if P doesn't divide A, then A raised to P minus 1 congruence to 1 modulo P. Okay, and second, for every integer A, A raised to P congruence to A modulo P. Okay, now let us see the proof of this. First one, what is given to us in first? P doesn't divide A. P is a prime and it doesn't divide A. And P is prime. If P is a prime and it doesn't divide A, then this gives this P and A are what? Relatively prime. These are what? Relatively prime. If this is the case, or I can write this as A and P are what? Relatively prime. If this is the case, therefore by Euler's theorem. Euler's theorem. What the Euler's theorem says? A raised to phi of p. Congruence to what? 1 modulo p. Now, you know if p is a prime, phi of p is nothing but p minus 1. Whenever I had taken the Euler's phi function, that time I had taught you this thing. That's why it is a raised to what? P minus 1 congruence to 1 modulo p. Since phi of p is what? P minus 1. This one. So, this is the proof of this first part. Now, the second part, what does this say? For every integer a raised to p congruence to a modulo p. So, let a belongs to what? Z. If p doesn't divide a, then a raised to p minus 1 congruence to what? 1. Congruence to 1 modulo p. That is same as to say a raised to p congruence to a modulo p. Multiplying both sides by a, we will get this. Now, another case, if p divides a, then what happens? Then, if p divides a, then p congruence to, then a congruence to 0 modulo p. It gives residue 0 if these are, this is divisor of the each other. That is same as to say a raised to p congruence to 0 modulo p. Using this two congruence, using these two congruence, a congruence to 0 modulo p, a raised to p congruence to 0 modulo p. So, from these are also what? Congruent. Using these two congruences. Using these two congruences, we get a raised to p congruence to whom? A modulo p. As such, we can prove the Fermat's theorem. This is also important one. Okay. Now, here we will stop this one. Now, in next video, we will see examples. Thank you.